Can I speak to you for a moment?
Sure. About what?
I know you're having a tough time getting on that ballot, but I think you have a real chance at becoming class president if you really want it.
What do you mean?
You need to rise above your ghetto mentality.
Ghetto mentality? I don't have a ghetto mentality.
You do, Chris. A psychological ghetto. You won't get supporters because you don't get out of your comfort zone. I'm sure all your athlete and dancer friends have signed on, but what now? You need to reach out, broaden your appeal.
And how am I supposed to do that?
I don't know, but I'm confident you'll figure it out. And remember, Chris, up with hope, down with dope.
I was thinking we should have another opportunity to hear our candidates in addition to the town hall meeting. So you're gonna have to prepare a speech.
A speech?
I never feared speaking in public until I had to speak in public.
No problem, Miss Morello.
Okay.
No problem?
You ever written a speech before? I haven't.
Oh, by the way, are you gonna need an organ player?
Why would I need an organ player?
Well, you know, in case you catch the Holy Ghost.
No, I think I'll be okay.
Tambourine?
I'm fine.
Good luck.
Didn't Ghostbusters already catch the Holy Ghost? Back at school, I stopped making promises and started making demands.
I'd like all book reports to be on books that were made into movies.
Are you high? I'm asking, not judging.
No. I'm just trying to fulfill my campaign promises.
Just for curiosity's sake, what else did you promise?
A TV in the library, more field trips, instituting recess, and no more detention.
Chris, how are you going to know how to act when you get stopped by the police if we don't give you detention?
And I can't do anything.
That's not true. Maybe you can talk them into letting you stay in office.
That's a good idea. Give another one of those speeches. But if I can make a suggestion, maybe this time, you should try rhyming.
Maybe you should try Prozac.
Oh, I tried, and it didn't work. Well, at least not yet. I still want to be your class president. It's just that I need another chance to make things right. Y'all believed in me before. You can keep believing in me now.
Fight the power, Chris. Fight the power. I hope everyone is prepared for today's history quiz. And Chris, I hope you weren't too busy taking care of all of your half-brothers and sisters to study. This time, sing it with feeling. You're singing about an impoverished family living in the ghetto who gave birth to their firstborn child in a manger. Chris, you can relate to this, can't you?
Not really.
Oh, poor Chris. Winters can be so tough when you can't afford heat.
I've got heat.
Chris, we have an uneven number of boys and girls, so I thought I'd make you a single father. I know it's something you can relate to with your childhood and all.
I have a father.
Oh, I know, Chris. If only your mom knew his name. Just so you embrace this project to the fullest, I brought something special for you.
If it's my baby's mama, I hope she doesn't have feathers.
A brown egg?
They're all the same on the inside.
Except my egg's gonna get pulled over by the police more. They even disrespected me during fire drills.
Oh, Chris, you go back inside and make sure nothing valuable burns. Chris! Can I speak to you for a moment?
Yeah.
So, Chris, I hear our newest hall monitor is making a big impression.
Thanks.
Chris, we're friends, right?
Yeah.
No.
I'm not part of the hall monitor program, but as a friend, I think you should slow down a bit.
Why? You just said I was impressive.
To me, yes. But to the rest of the students, well, they hate you.
They've always hated me.
True. But they used to hate you because you were black. Now they hate you because you're acting like a jerk.
And because I'm black.
So what do you mean?
You judo flipped Rodney for wearing a hat.
And I'm just doing my job.
I know how aggressive the downtrodden can get when they get a little taste of power. But Chris, you're just a hall monitor. Calm down.
Miss Morello's gonna be gone for like 2 or 3 weeks.
What?
Yeah. She went on a trip to Africa to help fight off an outbreak of yellow fever.
It was more like she went to Harlem to fight off an outbreak of jungle fever.
Miss Morello.
Oh, Chris, you're still here. I was so afraid the system would have brought you down by now.
We thought you were in Africa.
I was, but there was a civil war.
A war?
Fortunately, they found a way for all the white people to get out.
Same thing happened in New Orleans.
Chris, I love your shirt. What does it stand for?
B minus.
Oh, B minus. I love that black street slang. So what else did I miss around here?
Well, we were supposed to have a practice test on the statewide exam today.
Oh, forget about that test. I want to show you the gifts I brought back.
Gifts?
For you, I brought back a shield and a spear.
Well, what'd you get me? What is that?
It's a bone for your nose, silly. By the way, do you know a guy named Nduku?
Actually, I did, but I didn't want to give her the satisfaction.
Class, I just want to let you know that I won't be here tomorrow because I have a funeral to attend.
Who died?
My sister.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you, Chris. It's hard because I don't have 19 or 20 other siblings like you. Excuse me, can you be quiet?
Miss Morello? I thought you had a funeral.
No, stupid, she's at yours.
Chris, I'm sorry for shushing you. I know your people can't help talking in the movies. Why aren't you in school?
I wonder if she'd believe it was Chicken George Day.
Well, we just finished lunch and we figured we'd get a little popcorn and... Well, now we're on our way back to school.
Chris, please, don't insult my intelligence. It's obvious you and Gregory are playing hooky.
I don't mean to be disrespectful, but what are you doing here?
Well, Greg.
Hey, baby. I got the popcorn. You want Junior Mints or Goobers? I got both.
You're on a date?
Chris, we all grieve in our own way.
Grieve? Who's grieving?
Did you go to the funeral, too?
What funeral?
So you lied about your sister dying?
Yes.
Your sister died?
No.
How could you do that?
That's neither here nor there. The fact is, you shouldn't be here.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just wanted to see this movie. I didn't think missing one day of school would hurt.
Chris, I know you must be a big Ernie Hudson fan. That was his, too. But do you think Ernie Hudson cut school to go see Gary Coleman movies while he was growing up?
Gary Coleman made a movie?
Craig, you should be ashamed of yourself. You can see a white man in a movie anytime.
Sorry. Come on, Greg. Let's go.
Chris, wait. Stay.
Are you serious?
Yes. But don't you ever let me find out you've done anything like this again. You understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Could you not mention that you saw me here?
Yes, ma'am.
Nice meeting you.
Enjoy the movie.
Yeah.
Now, Chris, my request for the school to provide you with an alternate victory meal of ribs and pig's knuckles was denied. But I know as well as you do that you loves you some pizza, right?
Right.
Well, I'd like our class to win. But if you don't get your average up, that's not going to happen.
But I'm trying. I just don't get algebra. Maybe you can tutor me after school.
I'm sorry, Chris. I don't have time. Have you called the United Negro College Fund? Maybe they can help.
History would later prove her wrong.
All I'm trying to say is, if you don't get algebra, we don't get pizza.
And I'm gonna get sliced.
We'll be right back.